Labas, my name is Mangardas, and today we'll make the Flutter Design Patterns app responsive. First of all, what is a responsive design? In simple words, responsive design is an application design that adapts to various screen or view sizes, meaning you're creating a single application, have a single code base, but the design or at least the app's layout may be different on mobile, tablet, or web. Here is the current project that was designed specifically for mobile devices. If you have never heard of the Flutter Design Patterns app, it's the best and the most beautiful Flutter app out there that showcases all 23 design patterns in object-oriented programming that were described in the Gang of Four book. The homepage contains design pattern categories, a single category contains multiple design patterns, and each design pattern consists of two tab views. One of them is markdown file, and the other is an interactive example. This is the web version of the same application. As you may see, it looks terrible, there is no responsiveness, the elements are stretched. If we access the inner pages, the situation is the same. Let's think of some options on how to improve it. This is the current navigation workflow, where we have three pages or three layers in the navigation stack, which I have already shown you previously. This workflow works great on mobile devices, but it looks strange on the web, since you have enough space there to provide both categories and all the design patterns in a single view. To resolve this, we can completely remove the category page and access each design pattern from the home page. The question is how to rework this in a user-friendly way. The most straightforward solution to make it work is to have expandable design pattern categories on the home page that contain all the design patterns. On mobile view, you can expand each category individually, while on the web version of the app, all the categories are provided side by side. Since we have a lot of available space on the web version of the app, instead of having a separate task for markdown and example views, we can provide them side by side at the same time, reducing the navigation overhead to access all the available content. As you could see, the plan is very straightforward. We simply need to adjust the layout a little bit and use the available space more efficiently on bigger screens. Easy peasy, let's make it work then. The first thing we could do is to add a breakpoint for desktop screen size. Let's consider the desktop view width being 900 pixels and wider. Let's start from the categories or main menu page and rework the header. The header looks fine on small screen size, but on wider screen, I would prefer to fit this text in one line and also make it centered. First of all, we replace the container with layout builder and wrap the column widget. Then we create a variable to identify the current layout type. If the maximum width of the current view is higher than our desktop breakpoint value, we should use the desktop layout. Also, we create a variable for the header, format the text according to our layout type, and use it inside the text widget. Then, we adjust the cross-axis alignment, so for the desktop view, the header should be centered, while it should be aligned on the side for smaller screen sizes. We apply the exact same alignment trick for the created with Flutter and Love text. Now, if we resize the screen of our app, you could see that the page header is centered for desktop and remains on the side for mobile views. For the main menu page, we should create two different layouts, a vertical one for smaller screens and a horizontal for bigger ones. For that, we create a private widget main menu cards list view and pass the categories data from a snapshot. Then, again, we add a layout builder and define a variable to identify the current layout type. Also, a main menu cards iterable is created, since we'll use the same categories list, just the representation is different. For desktop layout, we use the constraint box to define the maximum area for the content and provide all the cards in a single row. As you could notice, an expandable widget is used, so all the design pattern category cards would take the same amount of space. Also, we add some spacing between cards using the addBetween method. If you wonder where this addBetween method comes from, it's just a custom extension method on the generic list type that basically builds a new list and inserts a separator object of the same type between elements. We are using this method to insert a widget between a list of other widgets, which is very helpful. Finally, we return a simple column layout for smaller screens. Now, if we check the layout, you could see that the cards are still provided in a column, but if we check the layout on a wider view, the same cards are provided in a row. Let's rework cards on the main menu page, so that we could remove the unnecessary design pattern category page later on. To begin with, we remove the code and implement a simple card widget with rounded corners, a specific color, and anti-alias clipping behavior to achieve a smoother look. For the child widget, we should create two different views, a scrollable one for desktop and an extendable one for smaller screens. Both of these views should accept a single design pattern category property. Since the header part is identical for both of these views, we create a reusable category title widget that is just a simple column with a bigger text for the design pattern category title and a smaller one to provide a design patterns count in the category. Also, both of these views should contain tappable tiles, so we could access the Design Pattern Details page straight away. For this, we create another private widget Design Pattern tile that accepts the info about the design pattern. For the tile, we use a combination of Material and Inkwell widgets to get the Material Ink effect and execute the onTap method to navigate the user to the Details page. The content of the tile is very straightforward. We use a column widget with some padding to provide the title of the design pattern and its description. Now, let's implement the specific use. For the scrollable view, we use a column widget and the previously created category title widget. Then, we add a separated list view wrapped with expanded. This way, the scrollable view would fill all the available vertical space for the content. Inside the builder method, we return the previously created design pattern tile widget, define the item count, and separate tiles with some spacing. To implement the expandable view, the most straightforward solution is to add the expansion tile widget. Then we apply some padding, coloring for the expansion icon, use the category title widget for the header, and render design patterns as a list of design pattern tile widgets with some applied spacing between them. Now we could see that the cards are expandable on a smaller view, but become scrollable on a wider one. After reworking the main menu, we can safely remove the category page from the app router and remove the whole category page folder. The next thing we should do is rework the Design Pattern Details page. To begin with, let's extract the Markdown and example code to separate widgets. For that, we create a Widgets folder and two separate view files, Example View and Markdown View. For the Markdown view, we just simply copy-paste the currently existing code from the Details page and put it here. For the Example view, we just simply pass the whole example widget and apply some padding to it. Correspondingly, we create a dedicated Layouts folder where we create two different layouts. Tabs layout for smaller views and single page layout for bigger ones. Since both of these layouts would use the identical app bar, we create a dedicated widget for that. We move the app bar code from the Design Pattern Details page. To be able to use this widget inside Scaffold, we should apply the Prefer Size widget interface and override the Prefer Size getter, which value is just a default toolbar height value. For the tabs layout, again, we just copy-pasted the existing code in the Design Pattern Details page. For the app bar, we use the new Details App Bar widget. The code for the bottom navigation bar did not change, but for the tab bar view, we are using the previously created Markdown and Example views. For the single page layout, we use the same Scaffold widget with Details App Bar. For the scaffold body, we use the row widget to provide the same two, Markdown and Example views, side by side. We should wrap these inside expanded widgets for them to take the same amount of space. Also, we use the vertical divider widget that basically draws a vertical line between these two pages with some indentation from top and bottom. All the layouts are created, now we just simply need to use the right one based on the view size. For this, we use the layout builder. There, we check if the maximum width of the current view is higher than our desktop breakpoint value. If the condition is true, we use the single page layout to provide markdown and example view side by side. Otherwise, the tabs layout is used. That's it. Now we can check how these two different layouts look like. As you could see, on a smaller view, we have the same tabs layout, but if we make this view wider, the markdown is provided on the left, while the example view could be accessed simultaneously on the right. All of the code changes for this rework are available in the pull request. You could find a link to it in the description down below. To sum up, there was no magic at all to make your app responsive and appealing on different screen sizes. The main widget we used was Layout Builder, so we could get the constraints of the current view and based on that render the right layout. The layout itself depends on your app design. In some cases you could change the layout drastically, but sometimes it is just enough to adjust the flow of your widgets, some sizing or spacing. Despite your choice, the fundamental blocks of the responsive design in Flutter would remain the same. Happy refactoring! As usual, I have a terrible joke for you. Why an introvert is not using any design pattern? Because he does not like having visitors. Thank you for watching. Save trees, stay solid, see you next time.